Do you know that you can apply a password to protect your Microsoft Project 2021 MPP file? Or do you know that you can indent and outdent your task without even clicking on the indent and outdent button on the project ribbon? In this video, learn the 10 less known secrets which very few people know about Microsoft Project 2021. By the way, who am I? My name is Varun and I am the founder and CEO of EduHubSpot. To make best use of video, I want you to pause this video. And on the link in the description, I have given a free tips and tricks file for you to download. Just go ahead and download that file to follow along with my video for the best experience. Welcome back. I hope you were able to download the tips and tricks file for Microsoft Project 2021. For now, I don't want you to do anything with that file. I want you to just keep it handy with you. I'll tell you exactly when to use it. So I've opened a blank Microsoft Project file. Just for the interest of this exercise, I will be using an already created template by Microsoft Project. So if you were here, select, you can see different templates. You can click on more templates and Microsoft Project has already created some templates for you. You can use any of them, it's totally up to you. Or, you know, I will just add a simple project plan. It's much easier and it will help us to give you those quicks and tips also. Okay, perfect. And for the interest, I'm gonna just put the duration of the last task as, let's say, something which I can't see, 20 days. Okay, perfect. Let's go into each secret one by one. Secret number one, how to apply the password protection. It's pretty simple. Click on the file tab and let's say I want to save as. Save as, I'll just do it on PC. I'll just do it on the templates, you know, wherever you want to save it. Over here, you see an option which says tools. Click on that tools option and click on general options. The moment you click on general options, it will give you two options, which says protection password and write reservation password. Protection password is that you want to, somebody to open this file, they can open it or not. Let's say I'm going to put a test. And then write reservation password is you are allowing somebody to make, you know, to have the write access. So let's say I will do test one and click on OK. Okay. Now the moment you do it, it will ask you to re-enter the password. Test. Okay. Re-enter the write. Test one. Okay. Perfect. And I'm clicking on. Let me just save it on desktop. So my project one is. Let me just reopen the project one so that I can show it to you. I go one, I double click on project one. Okay, and you can see that it says the file is protected. Let me put test. It says enter for write access or if you so test one. So now my file is password protected and you can see how it is done. Secret number two, the power of Ctrl+D and Ctrl+Z. Ctrl+D, you know, you might have used in Microsoft Word or other. Ctrl+D, what does Ctrl+D? Ctrl+D basically means copy. Let's say I'm saying task number one is being done by PM. Task number two, I'm saying that it's also done by PM. So all you need to do is, one way of copying it is you use the bottom arrow on the keyword and click on and type in Ctrl+D. The moment you type in Ctrl+D, it actually automatically copies whatever was written on the first particular column. Let's say I want to say that every task is being done by PM. Highlight the options where you want to copy and do Ctrl+D. But let's say I accidentally added it. Now I want to go back. That is your Ctrl+Z, which is undo. So Ctrl+Z, which means that is undo. So I've used Ctrl+D and Ctrl+Z a lot. It's much easier as compared to going on the top ribbon to make any changes. It's much easier. Secret number three, inserting multiple tasks at once. Now you can, let's say I want to add a single task. okay, in front of task number 3. What you can do, you can right click and you can say insert task. But let's say I want to add, you know, 4 more tasks. So all I need to do is select 4 columns, and then do insert task. It will add 4 new columns. That's the power of that is how you can actually add multiple tasks at the same time. Secret number 4, the power of highlight. Now click on the view option and see over here, you see a highlight option, right? Now what is a highlight option? Highlight option, it shows that let's say you can highlight all the critical tasks. So it will show you that all of these tasks are critical tasks. Okay, so it becomes much easier for somebody who just wants to concentrate on the critical task. They can actually do it. Then let's say it also shows the completed task or incomplete task, right? If you click on complete task, now nothing is completed because we don't have a new column. Let me add it for you. Let's say task number 1 is 100% complete, task 2 is 100% complete. And now if I do completed task, it will only show you, let me first go to no highlight. And now if I show completed task, it will show me that, hey, these are the tasks which I've already completed. So that's also one way of showing it. It can also, if I do incomplete task, it will show me that these are the tasks which are incomplete. So now that has changed to yellow color. Secret number 5, say no to delete. You cannot delete a column if added on Microsoft Project. Let's say I accidentally added, I wanted to insert a column, and let's say I want to add, let's say WBS. Okay, let me just go down. PQRSTUVW, right? Yes, WBS. Okay, I added a WBS column here. Okay, now let's say I don't want a WBS column over here, but I can't delete it because if you right click and see, there is no delete option over here. But how can I do it? One option is you can click on hide column. Hide column works exactly like your delete. So you can see hide column. That's exactly how it works. Or what you can do is you can use Ctrl+Z, which is undo. That will also, take you to the previous step. Ctrl+Z. Okay. So you added Ctrl+Z. You can see the WBS column is gone. So there are two ways how you can do that. Secret number 6. Can't find a task on Gantt chart. So let's say I'm on December 27. I can't find a task on the, you know, Gantt chart. How quickly I can go or what I can do to go to that particular task on my Gantt chart? It's pretty simple. Go on the task sheet and click scroll to task. The moment you click on scroll to task, you can see that this is where that time frame is mentioned. Scroll to task, most commonly used, my personal favorite. Secret number 7, wrap test and format painter. Now, if you see that, you know, it's not looking like, section 4, summary 1 complete is like bigger size, you know, task 1 and 2 is smaller size. Like, first of all, you know, let me just change the highlight because I don't like the highlight. No highlight. Okay. Now if you see that, you know, this is like bigger size and like, you know, this is different sizes. So it's not just looking neat and clean. And I want to make sure that, you know, it looks neat and clean. So basically all you need to do is right click and click on wrap text. So the moment you click on wrap text, you can see that, you know, the text has been wrapped and all the sizes are different. But now another way is like you cannot read the complete date of the start or finish. So all you need to do is just hover over it and, you know, stretch it the way you want to stretch it. That's another shortcut which is most commonly, you know, used to make it neat and clean as well. Also, let's say this is yellow color and let's say that, you know, hey, I want task number 4 also to be exactly same like task number 2. Just like exactly, let's say task 2 is also bold. Okay, I want task number 4 in the same way. So all you need to do is click on the format painter. Format painter exactly matches that particular tab or column or whatever you call, and just do it on task 4. So task 4 is now kind of replica of task number 2 because I use the format painter option. Secret number 8, the power of alt end and alt home. So basically I want to see what is the end date of my project and I have added so many tasks that it's not visible on the Gantt chart, right? All you need to do is on your keyboard click on alt end. The moment you click on alt end, it took me to the end date of the project, which is basically on February 2024, you can see over here, which is the end date. Now let's say I want to go back to the starting day, all you need to do is click on Alt Home and it shows me the first date when the project was actually started. Secret number 9, how to indent and outdent the task so quickly. Now, before I explain you the secret, I want to do something. Let me go to summary number 2 and I want to outdent it. Now, let's say I say that summary number 2 is my summary task and all of the sub keys, subtask over here are the subset of that. One way of doing intent and outdent is to click on these two options, which is the most commonly used. But when you are working on a project and you have to just do it for multiple things at the same time, then the best way to do is use your keyboard, and which is Alt, Shift and Right. So the moment you do Alt, Shift and right hand arrow on your keyboard, it automatically indented the task. Similarly, let's say I want to outdent, same process, Alt, Shift and do left arrow. Now it will show you that it has the outdent had actually happened. Lastly, and secret number 10, inserting hyperlinks. Now let's say I want to add a hyperlink. Okay, now I want to add a hyperlink over here. I want people to go on my website. Okay, so right click, you can see an option of link. Okay, you can add the address. Let's say I say www.3w's.eduhubspot.com. Okay, I can, you know, text the display. I can do click here if I want to, and it's actually HTTPS. Oops, not course detail. I just do it till spot.com. Okay. Now you see this option over here. This, and it says click here, right? This, if somebody clicks on this option, it will take them directly to my website. If I click on this, it will take directly to my website homepage, which is eduhubspot.com. I hope you like the 10 lesser known secrets for Microsoft Project 2021. Just in case, if you learned something valuable, please click on the like, subscribe and share this video with your friends, colleagues. Tell YouTube that this is one of the best video, and how would YouTube know when you actually like and comment on this video? So please don't forget to do that. And please, if you have any questions, you can reach out to me directly at varun.anand@eduhubspot.com. I personally reply to each and every email I get. So I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.